Brian, what is up? Good noise, good juju. Check this out. There's some really funky fresh shit going on here. People are doing crazy workouts, and me, I'm just gonna rap. I gotta clean off my camera. I'm just gonna rap about rib paint. Why? Because it's important. And me, I'm just gonna feed off all this energy. It's just what we're gonna do. So hey, listen. If somebody shoves me out of the way, it's because I'm in somebody's way, and they're all a lot bigger and stronger than I am. So what I'm gonna be talking about is how to open up that rib cage, but not so much that rib cage, it's that feeling like you have a knife down in your back. The issue is, it's not just the ribs so much as the entire thoracic spine and the mechanics of the scapula that come into play. So basically, this is a rib pain shoulder hack. So call it a rib hack. I don't know, call it whatever you want. All I know is this shit works. So what we need to do is we need to open up that thoracic spine, because the ribs move like a bucket handle. They have a contact on the front and a contact on the back. It's a costo transverse on the back and a sterno transverse, yeah, costo sternal junction in the front. So they have to expand and contract. It's like a bucket handle. If they can't elevate and depress, what happens is they start to jam up. And the intercostal muscles are so strong and so tight, you know, internal and external, they expand and contract that rib cage. What they do is they start to lock out that system. So that contact joint at that rib is really light. It's not like a ball and socket, it's really light. So as it slides off of the position it's supposed to be in, you end up with a lot of pain. And what happens is the mechanics of your entire thoracic spine, so basically from T12 up, so basically from about here all the way up, becomes compromised. So I'm going to show you the easiest way to undo how those ribs work and regain that rotation, that extension, and unglue that super funky rib pain that feels like somebody's stabbing right underneath your shoulder blade. Everybody knows what it feels like. This is what's going to happen. We're going to clear it out. So we're going to do three movements and one drill to basically reset and adjust that rib. So the first thing we're going to do is basically a PVC fulcrum. You've seen me do this before. The cool thing is that as we do this, you want to stay in this position for a long time, really full deep breaths, and here's why. Because it forces the ribs to expand and contract. So what we do is we take the foam roller, you want to put it just at the base of the shoulder blade, and then just hang out, 2 minutes, super easy. What's up, Jeff? You got to say hi to the big guys when they walk by. Alright, hang out like this for 2 minutes. When you're done, bring the elbows in and down so it's a little easier on the shoulder. That's number one. Number two, really straightforward. But you take a med ball. Doesn't matter the weight, I just want the med ball, because what you want to do is you want to open up that lateral position. So we get over the med ball. This hand here, you're gonna poke down here. I want that lower leg extended. You're just gonna bring your arm all the way over and really open it up. And I want you to hold back just a little bit. You're gonna hang out like this. 2 minutes, both sides, not just the side that hurts. That is number two. All right, now we got number three. When somebody calls in the middle of a video, you gotta retrain and redo everything, or you just kind of move stuff around and splice it together later. So what we do is, this one is no equipment, super easy. So you're gonna get in quadruped. So this is your position. You're gonna take the arm and you're gonna fire it all the way through. So this is gonna regain a lot of that rotation. So hand here, run the arm all the way through, and you're gonna really, really, so I'm basically in all fours. I'm gonna run that arm all the way through. I'm gonna take this hand and I'm gonna push into rotation. So I'm not trying to pull myself off the floor. I'm trying to push myself into rotation while staying square at the knees. So I'm pushing away on this hand, rolling everything over, hang out for 2 minutes, call it a day. That is number three. Number four. Oh, this is the janky one. This is the janky one, big time. So we grab a peanut. So if you don't have a peanut, what you do is you take a sock and you put two lacrosse balls in it. That's all you gotta do. So what you're gonna do here, this is important to understand, is you take the spine and you wanna cradle it between the two lacrosse balls. That's important. So we have the two lacrosse balls, cradle the spine in between there. That's so important, because otherwise what's gonna end up happening is you're gonna wind up jamming the bone together. So you cradle the spine, protect the spine. These are gonna make contact where that rib is contacting the transverse process of the spine. What's gonna happen is you're gonna gradually just kind of massage, and then click, it's gonna go into place. It's so easy. So here, check this out, so fun. I love all the music in the background. So we take this, it's light. I don't know what it is, but it's friggin' light. So we take the lacrosse ball, the double. So I am running that, the peanut, the double lacrosse ball, in the spine. So find out where that hot spot is. Take the kettlebell, wind it up so it's coming down the back side. One arm, so you're gonna go to the affected side. This is only for the affected side. You're gonna lay back, you're gonna find this, and all you're gonna do is you're gonna bring your arm slightly across, slightly back, wind it up, wind it out. So the important part is dragging that scapula across and then bringing it back. So you're forcing everything to do. Now the big, everything to move the way it's supposed to be. So all the way across, all the way back, wind it open, wind it closed. Do that until you feel that rib release. Once it releases, you're good to go. Hey, listen, I'm Travis SmashweRx, hanging out a killer CSA workout day today. I'll check you guys out tomorrow. Have an awesome day.